say there early on when I started playing guitar, I was always looking on what can make me better in blues and jazz, and I found Larry Carlton, which I know a lot of you probably have. He had a really cool lesson on how to use a technique that would complement the chord and make it very simple to play. We're gonna learn that. Here we go. This thing has really stuck with me for forever. It's basically what we're doing is we're able to take a set of chords and just a normal 12 bar blues, a 1-4-5, and we're able to imply the chords by only using two notes. We're using the third and the flat seven of the notes of the chord. So instead of playing the full chord, we're relying on the bass, keyboards, maybe another guitar to play. So that fills out the band mix and doesn't muddy it up and makes it sound awesome. So we're gonna have an example here. This is gonna be in the key of A. Let's get closer on the guitar and we'll show you how it works. Okay, so like I said, we're playing this in the key of A. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna play an A7 chord because that would be the one chord in the key of A. So that's the full chord, but we really don't wanna play the full chord because that's a little bit too much. So what we're gonna do is imply the chord by using this really cool two note method. So we're gonna play these two notes right here. This is on the D string, so we're on the fifth fret, and then this is on the G string, and it's on the sixth fret. So this is technically a G note and a C sharp note that we're playing. So that's all we're playing. So we would do it just like this. Then we could slide into it. And that's literally all we're playing. And you're like, wait, how in the world is that an actual A7 chord? Well, it's a partial chord, remember, because the bass player is gonna play the root, which is here, the A note, or the keys player or another guitar. So we are relying on them to play the rest of it. So this is great if you're playing rhythm and you're playing some lead. Let's say you don't want to get in the way. That's how that really works out well. So here would be, like I said, on the first part. So we would go. Okay, so that's the A7. So then typically the four chord is going to be a D. So we would play this chord. This chord is gonna be a D9. Like I said, we don't wanna play the root, so we get rid of this, the D note, and we just play these two notes. So these two notes are gonna be F sharp and C. So we just play these. And if you noticed, I just moved up literally from the A to the D sharp, to the D chord right here. So the best way to picture that is picture you're actually like this, but you're taking this finger off and you're taking the pinky off, so you're just keeping these. Or you can play it like this, either way is fine. So then, as you guessed it, the really cool thing is now we're gonna go down back here. This is on the E, which would be the 5 chord. Now we're going to play an E9, but we're going to drop the root and drop the pinky, and that gives us here, it gives us a G sharp note and a D note, and that's all we're going to play. Okay, so if you looked at the notes right here, you'll see that the A, when you bar it, that's the root. And then you'll see these notes that I've got highlighted here. This is how this is working. So we're dropping these extra notes and we're just keeping the third and the flat seven. So that's the A7. And then here is the D9. So we're dropping everything and keeping just the F sharp and the C. And then here again on the E9, which is the 5 chord, we're dropping the root of E and we're just keeping the G sharp and the D. And that's how this is working really well. I know you might be thinking it sounds a little weird, but in context with a full band, it works great. And I'm going to show you here in a second why it looks really amazing if you're trying to comp yourself and play some grooves. So for example, let's start here. We'll do the full full one just by itself, so a full 12 bar blues. This is the four, back to the one, go to the five, and that's it. That's all we do. So the beauty of that is it's opening these two fingers up, so now you can use them for other things that you need to use. So you could put some variation on them right here. You could tap on the pinky, so you could go. And then you come here. Something like that. So the other really cool thing, let's say you want to play this. So we go like this. Okay, I'm just showing you guys examples there. You can, let's play with a full band context so you guys can get better at that and understand what I'm saying here. Here we go. To the four. Alright everybody, I hope you guys really enjoyed the lesson. If you haven't, go ahead and like and subscribe to the channel. That will help me help you remember when new videos coming out. You guys don't miss that. In the meantime, check out another cool blues video I've done here that has a lot of really cool concepts on the blues and how things work together. Take care and have a great day. Thank you.